Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Kind of excited. We have two new books that came out this week. Excel for the CEOs. This is a great book for anyone new to Excel or anyone trying to run a small business with Excel. And my new book, Excel for Auditors, talks about all the great ways that auditors can use Excel using examples from the world of auditing. And speaking of auditors, this Thursday, October 19th, 2006, I'll be in New Jersey, right outside of New York City, doing a power Excel seminar for the Institute of Internal Auditors there. Even if you're not an auditor, you're more than welcome to stop by. 3 hours, great Excel tips that are useful to everyone. If you're not in New York City, upcoming dates, October 24th in Boise, October 27th in Akron, November 16th, Columbus, Indiana, just south of Indianapolis, recently added, November 17th in Cleveland, and November 30th in Green Bay. Stop by the website for information on any of those. I'd love to see you there. Make sure to come up and say, hey, we watched the podcast, and be great to meet some of the people that are out there. So, hey, let's do a quick example from the auditor's book. One of the kind of unusual tasks in Excel is we have a large database. We want to find the unique list of customers. Who are the customers who are in this 5,000 rows of data? The typical way that people try to do this is with advanced filter, which is kind of hard to do. I'm taking the customer heading and copying it over to the right of my data. And then in the data filter, advanced filter dialog box, I'm going to say that I want to copy to another location, and my copy to is the heading that has the customer field. And check the box for unique records only, click OK, and there is my unique list of customers out on the right-hand side. Kind of a lot of steps to go through. My better way to do this is to create a really simple pivot table. Select a single cell in your data, data, pivot table and pivot chart report, click finish, and then double-click the customer field. That simple, you have a unique list of customers. Now, if you want to use this for anything, of course, you're going to copy it and pay special value to wherever it needs to be, and then you could delete the pivot table. But using a pivot table is a much faster way to create a unique list of anything. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.